sake of love. It's gonna be a new day for you. New day for you. The stars have played their part. The past is gone and gone. Have more faith in love. The best is yet to come. So what is this I hear? You deserve a break. Take time to think it out. Don't make a new mistake. I am here, your help.
The past is gone and gone. Have more faith in love. The best is yet to
sake of love.
Hey. The stars have played their part. The past is gone and gone. Have more faith in love. The best is yet.
It's gonna be a new day for you.
A new day for you. New day for you. New day for you. It's gonna be a new.
Stars have played their part.
The past is gone and gone. Have more faith in love. Best is yet.
All right. Good morning. Thank you, Unity Band. Good morning, everyone. I am Margie Olson, privileged to be on your Board of Trustees, here to just give you a few announcements, starting with social media. So whatever devices you happen to have on you today, if you would feel so inclined, check in with them on your device. Let them know you're here. They are welcome here to experience this as well. And then please silence them to give yourself and the people around you the gift of this uninterrupted service. Okay, so a couple of other announcements. Today at 1:30, we're going to have our very first facilities and accessibility visioning session that kicks off the year of imagining what our transform space will look like. So you want to, you know, head out, do what you need to do, come on back, get yourself a box lunch for $5. Childcare will be available. And then at 1:30, we're going to meet here in the sanctuary. We're going to look at some slides and some videos. We're going to meet in small groups and make some, you know, do some envisioning and make some decisions. You want to be here. You do not want to miss this, kicking off our facilities transformation today at 1:30. And then on Thursday of this week, wrapping up Mike Dooley's series on infinite possibilities. So all are invited to attend Reverend Pat's 10:30 book group on Thursday, watch a video, and then stay for a potluck lunch. So you're all invited to that. As you might know, there's a lot of other things going on in this church at all times. Information is out in the garden court. Please check there, check in your bulletin. And then if you don't already receive the digital weekly peek at the week, you can just sign up for that out in the garden court and you'll learn about a lot more opportunities. And now Reverend Jeanette will lead us in prayer.
Let's take a moment for prayer. We thank you, sweet Spirit. We thank you for this day, for our spiritual community, for all that we are blessed with. We thank you for this magnificent day, and we are grateful. And so it is, and so we let it be. Amen. And now let's celebrate this glorious day. Woohoo! And let's stand for our opening song, Witness.
Yeah, if you're able to, please stand and join us in singing Witness.
And please be seated. Let me call your attention to our core values in your order of service. The value that we are honoring this month is welcoming, and this community has defined welcoming this way. We greet everyone warmly and open with a smile. Do you rate 1 to 10 on that?
10.
There's a 1 over here, a 2 over here, a 10 down here. Let's work it. So we greet everyone with a smile. And individually, how do we live this value? I am warm, open, and friendly with all my interactions. I put my best foot forward. I am respectful and gentle with myself and others. Now let's affirm together our core values found in your order of service. Together, we are loving, transforming, welcoming, spirit-filled, prosperous, and joyful. One of our core values is that of welcoming. Therefore, one of our favorite things to do here is to welcome you this morning. We certainly welcome those that are streaming with us today as well. I am so grateful that church was not canceled this morning, aren't you? I was on the news and we had some of our sister Unity churches cancel church this morning. My friend over in Eau Claire canceled church this morning. But I am so grateful that we didn't. I learned my lesson the first year I was here. not to cancel church. So we're just really grateful that you're with us. That's more information than you ever needed, okay? Needless to say. But obviously, one of our core values is welcoming, my dear friends. So if you're with us today for the first, second, or third time, we invite you just to take that deep breath. Nothing drastic is going to happen. Take a deep breath. Raise your hand as I raise my hand. First, second, third time guests, courage out here. Courage out here. And courage over here. Yes. Courage over here as well. That packet of information you received tells you a lot about Unity Minneapolis. There's also a card if you choose to fill out any part of that card and turn that into our book desk. We have a gift for you. The rose is a gift from our congregation so that we can easily recognize you and give you a very personal welcome. All of that's important, and yet one of the most important things that we say on this platform each and every Sunday morning is this. And that is, my dear friends, wherever you are on your spiritual journey, wherever that may be, you are welcome here. We welcome you. We bless you. We behold the living presence of the divine within you. And as we appreciate our guests this morning, let's appreciate ourselves for getting up and getting here. We can almost meet upstairs today. God bless you. Yes. Let's greet each other. We do it with a handshake, a hug, a smile, namaste. We always ask before we... Let's do it. Last Sunday afternoon, we had our annual meeting, and we had our election of the Board of Trustees, and the board has met, and they've also elected their officers. So this morning, we'll take just a few moments to really acknowledge our board, to appreciate our board, to share with you the officers for the next year, and then we're going to take a moment just to install them. So as I call your name, would you please come forward? Member-at-Large Judith Killian, Secretary Teresa Belton, Assistant Treasurer Jim Knapp, Treasurer Michael Showalter, not able to be with us today, Vice President Margie Olson, and President Greg Peterson. Let's appreciate our Board of Trustees.
All right.
We pause to remember our true nature as children of God, that the Spirit of God's love and light and life expresses through each and every one of you. And we know that your life blesses the lives of this community. You've accepted the office of Board of Trustees for Unity Minneapolis and expressed your willingness and desire to serve. Today, you make a public declaration of that commitment, which is the symbol of a commitment already made in your heart and made in spirit. We challenge you to remember that commitment is what transforms a promise into reality. Commitment is the stuff that character is made of. Commitment contains the power to honor the past and at the same time step boldly into the future, a future perhaps not totally yet imagined, but a future that is held in consciousness. Commitment is the daily moment-to-moment triumph of integrity over skepticism. Are you prepared to discharge the duties and responsibilities as a member of the Board of Trustees of Unity Minneapolis Do you always look to your inner Christ spirit for wisdom, inspiration, and follow the truth teachings and principles set forth by this ministry? If so, please say, I do. I hereby install you as members of the Board of Trustees of Unity Minneapolis. May you serve with peace, love, joy in all that you do, as that divine Christ presence expresses through you. Now then, our blessing for them is we love you, we bless you, we behold the living presence of God within you together. We love you, we bless you, and we behold the living presence of God within you. Let's appreciate these board members. Please. You may be seated. Now let's prepare for the reading of our daily word.
We now move deeper into spirit with the reading of the daily word. As the usher brings down the prayer box, you are invited to mentally add your prayers to the written requests in the box. After the service, the prayer box is located in the garden court, where you may add your written requests. Your prayers are then prayed with by our prayer ministry for 7 days, and then they are forwarded to Silent Unity, where they are prayed with for an additional 30 days. The word for today is guidance. I have faith that I am divinely guided. Today I consider the path that has brought me to this moment. Looking back at past situations, I now see that seemingly insurmountable obstacles held rich new opportunities to allow my Christ self to guide my every choice. Divine guidance is never withheld and is more rewarding than any scenarios my mortal mind may envision. Just as I encourage others to actively seek enlightenment from their inner source, I remind myself to do the same. Spiritual guidance is readily available to me and to all creation through a divine connection. Through spirit within, my perspective changes and possibilities become reality. I have faith that I am divinely guided. And scripture tells us in Psalm 32:8, I will instruct you and teach you the way you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you. The word for today is guidance.
You will do amazing. You will do amazing things. Amazing, amazing. You will do amazing things.
You don't have to work it out.
You don't have to work it out. Just say in the here and now.
Now let us join together in meditation. Gently close your eyes and allow yourself to center. Take a deep breath and relax into your seat. Focus on your breath in and out. In and out. No place to go, nothing to do, just breathing here and now. Allowing each breath to guide you to your still, calm center. In and out. Each breath guiding you to your oneness with spirit. These past weeks, we have been guided by lessons inspired by Mike Dooley's book, Infinite Possibilities. And today I want to share a few of his words from the final chapter of that book. You are the prodigal child who's lost your way. Yet the universe blesses your wandering and is anxiously preparing for your return at a moment's notice. Not to some celestial heaven away from the earth, but to a heaven here on earth, right now. And though you've momentarily forgotten where you came from, the universe has never left you. And the world remains your oyster. You're not here to experience lack, disease, or limits. You're here in this very lifetime to experience abundance, health, and harmony. That is your purpose. To follow and live the life of your dreams. Understand this. Believe in your sovereignty. Choose your thoughts accordingly. And live your amazing, extraordinary life. Let us take the power of those words with us into the silence. And now I ask you to take another deep breath and silently affirm with me, I am here in this lifetime to experience abundance, health, and harmony. I am here to live the life of my dreams, and I choose my thoughts accordingly. Another deep breath. Coming back into the room, back into this time and space. And when you are ready, open your eyes.
Proudly, in true peace of mind. We're going to go. Mm-hmm.
And it's always great to have you with us. Glad you're here. A man was sitting on the edge of the bed watching his wife, who was looking at herself in the mirror. Since her birthday was not far off, he asked what she'd like to have for her birthday. "I'd like to be 8 again." Still looking in the mirror? On the morning of her birthday, he rose early, took her a big bowl of Cocoa Pops, and then took her to Adventure World theme park. What a day. He put her on every ride in the park, the death slide, the wall of fear, the screaming roller coaster. Everything was there for her. 5 hours later, they staggered out of the theme park. Her head was reeling and her stomach felt upside down. He then took her to McDonald's, where he ordered a Happy Meal with extra fries and chocolate cake. Then it was off to the movies, popcorn, soda pop, and her favorite candy, M&M's. What a fabulous adventure. Finally, she wobbled home with her husband, collapsed into bed exhausted. He leaned over his wife with a big smile and lovingly said, "Well, dear, what was it like being 8 again?" Her eyes slowly opened, and her expression suddenly changed. "Are you crazy? I meant my dress size 8. I think I'll retire that one, Pete. Don't you think so? You know, we continue and we finish our series, The Art of Living Your Dreams, based on the book by Mike Dooley. We have really covered a lot of ground in the last few weeks. The first thing that we covered, you might remember, was that we taught and we believe and we teach that thoughts are things, right? Thoughts are creative, right? We touched that. That ties into our third basic teachings, that thoughts held in mind produce after their kind. So the reality that we're experiencing right now, we've had something to do with. We all in agreement with, I won't ask for a show of hands on that right now, okay? But most of us would probably be in agreement with that, that thoughts are things, and they are indeed creative, and they have something to do with the life that we're experiencing right now. Therefore, if we want to change our lives, we change our thoughts, and we create differently. That's why we're co-creators with God. And we also looked at the importance of our belief system. Our belief system came along with a lot of different ways they came along, but most of us picked up these beliefs as children along the way. We added things to them. We picked them up along the way. And it's a total belief system. Sometimes we look at our total belief system as a total consciousness of our superconsciousness and our subconscious mind. And so this belief system, our thoughts come through that. We can have the thought, as I use, I am prosperous, but at the same time, if we have the belief system of lack, then that thought is not going to show up as I am prosperous, and our life is not going to show up as I am prosperous. It's going to show up as I experience lack in my life. So the belief system is important in our life. We get to look at that. We get to look at our belief system. We also get looked on this covering of ground in relationships as well. Sometimes we looked at how, you know, we go from one relationship to another relationship because we have not changed our belief system. We've not changed. And so if we don't change our belief system, then we're going to repeat it over and over again. You know how the people are. They go out, they change clothes, they just have a different face on. If you notice that, they keep showing up in our life. And it's because of our thoughts and our belief systems as well. So it's really important for us to become aware of that. And Mike Dooley says that if we want to live the life of our dreams, whatever that may be, that we have to be clear about those dreams. We have to have a clear vision of those dreams. That's exactly what we do in our own life. That's exactly what we do as a community as well. He also talks about holding this vision out here and the importance of holding that vision and not be caught up necessarily on how that is going to happen in our life. He says sometimes we get caught up into the cursed hows. How is it going to happen? And he says our job is to hold that vision and then to take action. He says basically we can't sit around in our house thinking and visioning all day long, even though that's an important part of it, right? At the same time, we have to step out and we have to interact with the world. We have to interact with the world, and that's how the universe, there's many different names for God, right? And his word, his name for God in this book is the universe. But that's how the universe orchestrates things to begin to happen in our own life. Today we conclude this series with the meaning of life. More than once I thought, I'm not going to stand up here and tell you the meaning of life. What do you think you are, Pat Williamson? Who in the world do you think you are? You're going to stand up here and tell this congregation the meaning of life. Yep. Well, thank you very much, okay? I know that's probably what you pay me to do, okay? But needless to say, let me just share with you, this lesson title came right out of his book, The Meaning of Life. And I thought it was very interesting. If you will go to the front of your bulletin, you might have noticed that, you might not have. But what is the meaning of life? I believe with all my heart, what is the meaning of life? Whatever you want it to be. So I'm not going to tell the meaning of life for you. It's what you want it to be. And it's what I want it to be. But the important thing is we can co-create with Spirit the life that we want to live. We can co-create with Spirit the life that we want to live. And one of the ways that we co-create with Spirit the life that we want to live is through this power that so often we forget in our life. And that power is the power of... Oh my goodness, we've been together for 42 years. The power of imagination. If we can conceive it in our mind and we can believe it in our heart, then we can achieve it in our life. But first and foremost, what happens is so often in our life, we just want to life happen to me. Just life is doing it to me. And guess what? Life doesn't do it to you. Life doesn't do it to me. We have the power to co-create our life. We have the power to co-create that life through the power of our imagination. To become clear about what we want our life to be and to see it and to hold it and not get caught up in those blessed hows. Charles Fillmore, co-founder of our Unity Movement, he says this about imagination. It is the faculty of mind that images and forms, the power to shape and form thought. With our imagination, we lay hold of the ideas and clothe them with substance. That is the power of our imagination. Neville Goddard, another phenomenal teacher of mine, and he's a great writer as well, he says, imaging creates reality. We just said that. Imaging creates our life, creates reality. An awakened imagination works with a purpose. It creates and conserves the desirable and transforms or destroys the undesirable. How do we destroy the undesirable in our life? We stop giving attention to it. We stop putting our power in it. And suddenly it's not a part of my life. And how do we create? We give it attention with the power of our imagination. He goes on to say, Men, women pay too little attention to this priceless gift, the human imagination. And a gift is practically non-existent unless there's a conscious possession of it and a readiness to use it. Now, what I loved about Mike Dooley's teaching in this book about that power of imagination, he says that all we really have to do is use it twice a day. Visualize 5 minutes in the morning and 5 minutes in the evening of what you would like to achieve in your life. And as I pointed out, that's different from meditation. For me, that's different than meditation. Meditation is emptying my mind or being in the stillness. But the imagination is active. It is using that imagination to see and help co-create with Spirit those things that I want in my life. Not just things, but the qualities that I want in my life as well. He goes on to say in the same book, every image can be embodied, but unless you yourself enter the image and think from it, it is incapable of birth. Hear that. this image that we are imagining in our life. We want to see ourselves in that image. We want to see ourselves in that image, not someone else in that image, but you. Last week, we talked about the importance of a vision board and using that as a tool for visualization, putting ourselves in the image. So it's important for us to see it. We see it created, not so get so caught up in it. But have you ever noticed sometimes that the law of imagination, it can really take you down very quickly. If you notice that in your own life, you have sometimes, maybe I should speak for myself, sometimes I have a tendency to go to that negative place. Does anybody else have that tendency? God, come on up here and stand with me, Tony, you know what I mean? But like, for example, let me just give you a little quick thing. Often on Sunday morning, I'll drop by Byerly's. They know me by face, by name. Hi, it's cold outside. Yes, it is. I'll have Earl Grey tea. Thank you. So we go, and we go into Byerly's, but on the way into Byerly's, there was an ambulance coming. It was whirling, and it was going toward Covenant Village. My first thought was, oh my goodness, and I thought of the people from this beloved congregation that was at Covenant Village. And my mind went right there. Oh, my goodness. I hope it's something, blah, 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 blah. Suddenly, I said, what am I teaching this morning? What am I teaching? Change your thoughts. Change your imagination. And see it differently so that you don't continue to create the things in your life that you don't want. You know, I love one of the teachings of Mary Morrissey. She's one of the prosperity teachers that we use. And she says, she uses the cable. In our home, we don't have cable. In fact, we don't have a television, but that's another story. But most people have cable, and they have thousands of channels. She said you can have 500 to 1,000 channels on cable. Does anybody have that many channels? They make that, don't they? Oh, my goodness. She says, suddenly, if you don't like what you're watching, you can just change the channel. Change the channel. Click, 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 click. Go to the Discovery Channel rather than the Fox News or CNN or whatever you're using. Go to that Discovery Channel. And she compares that for us to the power of our imagination. She says, once we start thinking something, shout out, change the channel. Change to the channel. And we have the power to do that. And as we continue to change the channel in our life, then we begin to co-create differently in our life. We begin to see things different. You know, and so I want to encourage you to often check your channel that you're watching and change that channel. Mike Dooley, in his book and in his chapter on the meaning of life, he says that the meaning of life is about being. He says it's about being. And I want to just share a little bit about what he has to say about that. He says, as we continue to work these principles, as we continue to utilize these principles and co-create our life, he says, of course you'll notice that something else strange happens. Physical principles have begun taking a back seat to spiritual principles. Less no longer means less. Get that? Less no longer means less. Logic no longer applies. You find that the more you give, the more is given to you. The more you teach, the more you're shown the way. The more you heal, the more you're healed. And everything you do seems to get simpler and easier by the day. Life seems to be so fair, so rich, so abundant, and love is everywhere. You wonder how it had ever escaped you before. And I believe with all my heart that the more that we stay in these teachings and the more that we stay in these principles, then what happens is we are more and more about being. Seeking ye first the kingdom of God, and then all this material things will be added unto us. But don't poo-poo the material things. Thank God we have a teaching that helps us to pay our rent, helps us to do other things in our life as well. Eden pointed out to us in her meditation that we are divine, that we are powerful, unlimited, and eternal. We are also invincible. Those of you that follow me on Facebook, that would be about three of you. So those of you that follow me on Facebook, you know that my you know that my very good friend and my mentor and just a beautiful soul, made his transition on Monday of last week. That has touched me, and what a week, you know, the meaning of life. And suddenly this man makes his transition. And suddenly, well, it wasn't suddenly, he was 95 and had been ill. But he made his transition, and I thought, you know, this lesson title was picked months in advance. And he makes his transition for me to look at the meaning of life. This man, I cannot share with you enough, and I'm just going to take just a moment. Will you allow me to do that, just a moment, to share about this man and how he's influenced my life? He was a mentor and a teacher and a minister in Oak Park, Illinois, for 50-plus years in the same church. God bless him. How did he ever survive? Oh, my gosh. It's wonderful. 50-plus years in the same church. But this man was a man of purpose, and that's important for us to know. It's important for us to know our purpose. If we know our purpose, then the Spirit within helps us to co-create that purpose in our life. Do you know your purpose this morning? Mine is to teach and preach universal truth principles so that I may grow spiritually. And the result, you can too, you know? But it's about me. And it's okay to have a purpose about you. That man had a purpose, and he had a purpose about service. He installed me in this church. He installed me in the church in Evanston, Illinois, that I also served. When I stepped into Evanston, Illinois church, he was cooking for the staff every day. I said to the staff, which consisted of me and two other people, I said, "We will not be cooking every day." That was the kind of man he was. He was a man of purpose. He was a man of passion. He was passionate about what he did. Oh, my goodness. He loved ministry. He loved people. And as I said in my posting, he was a minister's minister. Hundreds of us called and sought his counsel often. And I can just hear him now. Now, Pat. And that was when he took me into prayer. He was a man of prayer. And yet he understood these principles of thoughts held in mind produce after their kind. I could hear him saying, "We must change our thinking. We must change our thinking." As he would say, and he was a good friend with Eric Butterworth, another one of my fabulous teachers, he said, ours is not to set it right, it is to see it rightly. And only when we see it rightly in our mind, then do we take the action. We see what we want to accomplish in our own life. The man was truly a man of purpose and a man of passion. And I can remember a couple of times when I've called him and I felt like I had lost my passion. Passion for my relationship, passion for the ministry, passion for something out there. Have you ever felt like you lost your passion? You were called to something. You were very passionate about it. It was your marriage. You remember when your marriage was so rich? Maybe it is right now. Praise God it is. Maybe your marriage was so rich you could hardly stand to do sex, drugs, and rock and roll together, you know? And suddenly, marriage rich. He says, "Pat, when you lose your passion, especially around your purpose, you have to fan the flames." And he was talking about, of course, 1 Timothy chapter 1, 1 through 6. When the Apostle Paul is writing to his beloved Timothy, he says, "Timothy," let me just share it with you. The words are too beautiful not for me to paraphrase. It's just absolutely beautiful. He says, "Timothy, I thank God for you. He is the God I serve with a clear conscience, just as my ancestors did. Night and day, I constantly remember you in my prayers. I long to see you again, for I remember your tears as we parted, and I will be filled with joy when we are together again. I know that you sincerely trust the Lord, for you have the faith of your mother, Eunice, and your grandmother, Lois. This is why I remind you to fan into flames the spiritual gifts that God gave you. Wow. Would we get to that point of not having passion anymore around our purpose? Then it's time for us to fan the flames. Those of you that have gone out camping, been a few times, but those of you that's gone out camping, you know that when the fire goes out and the embers are still burning, that you don't have to go get the log and put it, you may have to get the log, but you don't have to start the kindling again. It needs more oxygen. You fan it and the flames come up. And that's what we are called to do when we so often forget our passion around our purpose. And that is, my friends, is to begin to, that power of gratitude flames those fans. This pattern of seeing it right flames those fans. That pattern of making new choices fans those flames. That fans that flame, and it raises up again. Richard was a man of purpose. Richard was truly a man of passion. He was a man of prayer, and he was a man of peace, Wow. He was about peace within first. And that's what I think we are called to be. So often we want to go change the world before becoming peaceful within ourselves first. And only by becoming peaceful within ourselves first can we go out and make a difference in the world. And maybe Richard, when it came to peace, God bless you, Richard. Maybe when it came to peace, maybe he was conflict avoidance. You know, you've ever heard that term before? I avoid conflict. Richard did. He was a minister. And he would always call us back to a higher place, a higher purpose in our life, and always call us back to principle in our life. A great man. Richard was a firm believer in reincarnation. In fact, he wrote a book, My Soul Remembers, and it tells of his story of the different lives that he feels that he had lived in the past. My Soul Remembers by Richard Billings. So I ask you to hold that community of Oak Park in prayer. I ask you to hold his good friend, you can remember that generation, good friend John in prayer too. Hold that in prayer as well. And this is your assignment if you choose to accept it. You know, how could you leave without an assignment? This is your assignment if you choose to accept it. I want you to like very much, and those several of you, by the way, when I showed my vision board last week, many of you came back this week and showed me their vision board. Some of them were just amazing vision boards that they shared with me. So you haven't done a vision board, that's an important process as well. But this week, what I want you to really do is work with the power of your imagination. I want you to notice what you're noticing. I want you to notice the channel where your imagination is. And when your imagination is on that channel that no longer serves you, then change it. Change the channel. Think of something different. Think of something that's creative. Think of something that you want to create in your own life. How you doing out there? I love you. I bless you. I behold the living presence of God within you. And so it is. Amen.
Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. I've time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and leave. someone says they're so. Some things I cannot change, but till I try, I'll never know. Too long I've been afraid of losing love, I guess I've lost. Well, if that's love, it comes at much too high a cost. I see when I ride a fine gravity. Future is unlimited, and I've just had a vision almost like a prophecy. I know it sounds truly crazy, and true, the vision's hazy, but I swear someday I'll be.
Invite our ushers to come forth as we prepare to receive our tithes and our gifts and our offerings. And if you're streaming with us today, we invite you to make a gift to Unity Minneapolis. You can do so on our secured website. So let us go within again and just feel that divine presence as it moves through us today, as the activity of love and the activity of life, giving thanks that we have the power within us to co-create our life. I'll affirm our church offertory blessing once, then ask you to affirm it with me and then silently. Divine love flowing through me blesses and multiplies all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I am. Together, divine love flowing through me blesses and multiplies all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I am, and silently. Thank you, God. Amen.
Let us turn our thoughts today to Martin Luther King and recognize that there are ties between us, all men and women, living on this earth, ties of hope and love, sister and brotherhood. We are bound together in our desire to see the world become a place in which our children can grow free and strong. We are bound together by the task that stands before us and the road that lies ahead. We are bound, we are bound. Thank you.
Let us take just a moment as we give thanks. We bless these gifts. We bless the gifts that's been received in the mail this week. We bless those participating in our consistent giving program, our unexpected income program. We bless all of these gifts, and we send them forth to fulfill our vision and mission, truly, of a transformed world. Thank you. Thank you, God. And so it is, and so we let it be. Amen. Thank you, Lori Dockin. I like that very much. Thank you very much. I'm going to invite our on-duty Unity Prayer chaplains to please stand. These individuals arrived early. They held sacred space in this sanctuary. And today they've stepped into service. They're here to hold that sacred space with you, to listen with the ears of their heart, to pray aloud with you, and then to hold what they have heard in the strictest of confidence. So today, if you have a prayer request, by all means, seek out a Unity Prayer Chaplain. Thank you. Thank you for your service. And you may be seated. If you want to take your spirituality, I believe, to a deeper level, then one of the ways to do that is to become a member of our community. There's something about ownership and membership in our community. We do membership classes twice a year. Reverend Jeanette, along with our guest, we have special guests coming in for this class, begins this membership class, I believe that is on March the 6th for four Wednesday nights, for 2 hours each time. Come and be a part of that. And then next Sunday, after the 11:30 service, we do Coffee, Tea, and Reverend Pat. And Coffee, Tea, and Reverend Pat is a great place to come and get your questions answered and your answers questioned. So come and be a part of that next week. Also, we start a brand new series next week that I'm excited about. Part of our mission here is that of education. And so we will begin next week looking at oneness. We'll be looking at oneness in some world religions, not necessarily the major world religions, but we'll be using the book by Houston Smith, World Religions, and we'll be looking at that, and then we'll be teaching that class on Thursday morning. And next week, we begin our series, Unity and Christianity. Have you ever been asked, is Unity Christian before? Is Unity Christian?
Yes.
Come, and let's explore that next week, okay? So come and be with us next week. I hear children out there, I believe. Let's stand and let's bring them in.
You know what, Reverend Pat, I'm going to interject one quick
thing. Yes, interject.
Dave Burgett will be back next week, by the way, from Florida. Liz Draper is in New York with the Okie Dokie Brothers at the Sirius XM Radio Studios. So today we have the fantastic, legendary Joan Griffith.
Joan Griffin.
It's her first time today, so thanks.
Welcome.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm your new Youth and Family Ministry Director. My name is Cassidy Meeks, and we had a great time upstairs. We did a combined classroom, so yay to these two volunteers for really rocking it. Also want to say this is your invitation if you have a passion for these types of youngins and would like to be involved in curating an amazing extravaganza, which is our Easter egg day, the Saturday before Easter, come talk to me. We would love to have you on that team. Thanks, everyone.
Absolutely. Thank you. And this afternoon at 1:30, we begin a conversation about our facilities, the space, and how we can utilize the space, what we want to do to make us more welcoming. We are open and welcoming, inclusive community. As you know, we have accessibility issues here as well. So come and enter into this conversation this afternoon at 1:30. So how are you guys doing? Let us know together our prayer for protection and our peace song. The prayer for protection is printed in your order of service. We've changed that recently. So let us know together that the light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence. Wherever we are, God is. I am divine, and all is swell. And speak to our guests today.
Ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
Parade?